and dire not been picked up, pick. And I don't really feel like there's not a reason to go for Magnus this game. I guess for Clutch Smith to share the bottom two, they're not going to pick it up. And now they're taking a fight in the meantime, as the Mothling and the Destructor will both drop down in that Monkey King's ultimate. Juggernaut using his Omni Slash as well, and they just set up to kill off the kill Nagasan. We'll go for Sleeps, trying to set up for a fight. They go in, but Rabby goes for the Doom on the race, not letting him use his Static Storm, and Rabby tries to get him away in the meantime. He's going to be healing up a little bit. In comes Dr. the Juggernaut, they will get the kill on the race, and with that Doom setting up for it perfectly, the Nagasan is hiding close in the trees right now. Bond Effect comes up from the and that is going to be Nagasan dropping down as well. The Abaddon looks like it's opening for the next 6 seconds. Not going to be good enough. He gets it in also. This guy is just going to be wrapping up that goal as fast as you can possibly imagine. Abaddon goes up with ultimate for now. Got to go for the long Fly Solo. Fly Solo will be taken down. Gabby's still having that healing board available. The healing board will be taken down by the Abaddon. Now Gabby's going to be run down. Getting some shots, trying to do a little bit of damage to that Abaddon, popping the shield, trying to kill very, very desperately. He will go in front of him with the Monkey King, the shield. Gabby will be killed by the Plasma Shield from Trackbox. We'll be using that as a flash game. So we'll get the third one. The Monkey will be dropping down. It's a decent timing on the Radiance, but is it going to be good enough? That's the question. The team is dropping right now. There's more than going on. The Abaddon gets through, so Monkey King ultimately comes out as well. The only thing we've done up to begin with, he does not have what it takes to use his mechanism. He will use it now. Barely keep Fly Soul alive on that Shadow Shaman. They will get the kill on the Abaddon first, and that is going to be the Abaddon using his ultimate and still dying afterwards with that Doom coming out on top of him, just making sure that Rappy just making sure that the race is not doing anything to play them. But looks like Doom will be taken down by that Plasma Shield as they get one kill, maybe another one. They're moving in the ones of contestants. They have the sleep available. They go in, they pop the sleep, but already Clutch Gamers, they have already moved themselves a little bit away. But that is a very nice static stomp. They set up for the static stomp. He comes out, the Doom is going to be a little bit trouble. Doesn't get to use the Doom right now. The Monkey Nolte comes out. In the meantime, trying to turn around the situation. He's going to have himself in the trees. Sad Boy might be a little bit trouble. He's going to take a lot of damage in this Monkey King's ultimate. He will be killed. Mothling and Razor both are stunned. The Mothling is going to be stunned up. Control up for a little while, but the Miller Rage is going to be taken down. They go in, Sad Boy continues to go down. The beast first down, Omnisex comes out, Razor might be a little bit in trouble, so Red Trigger can be effing on him, and he's going to be killed 80 seconds with the sidelines on Sad Boy. Bad Gabby goes in further. Nice blast coming up from Slogan, but he wants to kill people on Nagasan. Slogan controls, and that is going to be the Minerite dropping down. Shadow Shaman gets stunned up, they need to get themselves out of here now. They have 20 seconds cooldown on that healing wall, looks like Shadow Shaman might be a little bit in trouble. They're trying to reinitiate. They go in, they want to take the fight in the end. As they go in, Abaddon will pop his ultimate again. Nagasan might be a little bit in trouble himself. Shadow comes down on the Juggernaut, he might be controlled. He still has that Aegis in the air, but looks like this might be a little bit bad for Clutch Gamers. They pop the BKB again on Bombback, trying to fight up against the enemy team. Doing his very best at just pushing them back. The Aegis will drop down. Gabby will use his healing water. Oh yeah, and I forgot. It's not the enemies you can use. Like, allied heroes. Oh, look, yo, Aghanim Scepter, Static Storm. The Founder Strike though might be able to give enough time for the Juggernaut to be able to survive. He's going to be hit by that Static Storm, taking a lot of damage. Well, will get himself out of that kinetic shield though. Looks like the Monkey Ultimate is doing a lot of work. That Founder Strike might have saved that life of the Juggernaut, pushing back for fire production. They're trying to run off one. Doom comes out on the Abaddon. He's going to be muted. He's going to be unable to use anything here, and he will be killed. As the Abaddon will be the next one dropping down. The next 50 seconds on that Doom as well, so you can get that extra use of ultimate. Full strength use with Midas as well, you know, Midas has more than anything on the team that's going to be able to get control stun, static stun comes out, control the monkey team, so it's going to be able to get down, and that's the Nagasan is going to be taken down with that Doom coming out on top of him. He will be killed, and Doom gets one kill. He just has this refresher available in 2 seconds, we'll be able to go into another use of it. But everyone is going to be put down the meantime. They try to go for the tier 4 towers, and he's good, goes in, oh, goes for an ultimate on one of the illusions. Illusion, my friend, that is not the real Nagasan, and the Nagasan is target the server lord, first server lord, so this needs to be taken down. They already used the monkey ultimate, they already used the double doom. Can they take this fight? Gabby needs to be a little bit defensive. He does have his Omni Slash available, but he cannot go in and use it. Nagasan is taking the meantime, comes in, they go in, they pop a lot of illusions, they try to use as many illusions as humanly possible. And let's see, can they get some kills? Gabby, he's get himself out of there. We'll have a healing board available, pop some shield more, both of them survive for now, not having to use that ages, like, he gone back to my jumping down here, though. He's a little bit of trouble, like, he moved past that ice where he could be eaten by Bombax and survives. That part will be the target now that he's going to be taking down Abaddon. Also, like, it's probably when the other side comes up. And he's going to get the kill on the Mothman, so the Mothman gets taken down. Two people dead inside of 4-Fire Production. They have buyback wheel on the Razor, but they call it GG. They know this is the end. There's just nothing left. They used everything they tried. They have buyback on Razor, but what is the point when your Mothman is dead? As without the Mothman, they can't take this fight. Alright guys, it was very difficult to do as 458 Productions draft was actually very very annoying to deal with. Squishy heroes, so I don't know. When in case of emergency use, level 3 as well as the top one guy goes in, that boss will take a lot of damage. He does have that shadow work killing him up, but it's not going to be enough as he will be picked off. In the meantime, the warlock is going to be gone as well. The sunfire comes up, and that is going to be good grabbing down as well. Double kills to Gabby. Time as a position for support as well. Moving towards his blink dagger next. Will take him a long time, of course, but yeah, moving towards it nonetheless. RP is going to be available on the Magnus. He's in this in the top lane. I'm not sure he wants to use the RP for the sanction. So I'm pretty sure they want a bigger kill. But in the meantime, the warlock is going to be run down. The warlock might be a little bit in trouble. So Kuji comes off and Gabby will be able to get a kill on this guy. Time as comes out. Magnus trying to go in position, does have his RP available, does go to the RP, does the pressure, he goes to the RP, Sunfire comes out, but the general will be picked off, not able to get anything off, he's still not level 6, didn't get to use his Omni Slash there, because he didn't get his level 6 in time, but he will be picked off, thank you, will be dropped down, and that is going to be the CM. What I mean, dude. Goes in for pushing over the bar cycle, so the Sunfire can tell what that's doing. Michael probably is taking a lot of damage here. Goes for a nice Sentinel Storm that might actually give him enough time to get out of here, but he's going to take so much damage. Gabby wants to bring him down, he will get the kill, as that is going to be a dead Doom. The Rubik might be a little bit in trouble as well. Tries to get a kill on the Fly Soul. In the meantime, Fly Soul trying to do his way through things, but he's going to be picked off. Tanky might also be a little bit in trouble. Salute gets one kill, Salute gets two kills. He goes, oh, he goes for the stick. He gets another Tsukuchi off, and he's going to be able to survive the fight with his team. He'll run in, he'll push back these heroes unless he's going in. Bombax will go and get a 2-man bar strike off that, but in the meantime, he's going to go a little bit of damage off. They go for the RP, they hit a 2-man RP. That is going to be a big one. The clone comes out on top. Gabby gets his time lapse off before dying there. The ultimate comes out to the Abaddon as well. He will be able to survive as well. He comes out to the sidelines from the invoker. The clone is going to be controlled for now. Rapid is going to drop down very, very low. He does not have his ultimate available right now. So in the background, will be picked off. The Magnus gets killed by Gabby. In the meantime, the roller gets killed as well. Melk is invisible. Juggernaut's going to be controlled. The CM ultimate comes out, flies out. The Sunfire comes out on top of the Juggernaut. And that is game. The bar strike up on side, but he actually managed to dodge the gun strike. From there, Bombax will be able to survive for now. Bar strike comes out, he survives still live, but no, he gets hit one more time, and they did have a thing put down in place already, so we'll get the kill either way. Anki will be killed. So in the meantime, Michael is in trouble. They're trying to run them down. They're trying to get another kill. The CM is going to be the next target. If you want the Omnisphere and Stunner, that boy does not want to use it right now. The Apothic Shield. But on pops his ultimate for now. Radiance might be a little bit in trouble as he does not want the armor that he goes to protect that one. He'll go for an armor that he will hit it on Grabby. Grabby might be a little bit in trouble. Might be able to put a knife if he wants to. And he's going to run away. He will get away. He does have another perfect shield available. He will be able to survive. In the meantime, the warlock gets picked up. The Doom goes invisible. Will survive for the moment. Shadowblade. He's going to take this. But we'll see. Smoke on the side of Fulfire in the meantime. They're trying to get an RP. Backlands. Nice RP. 3-man RP. That's a goal on the top. And that's a big hit of bombs as well. Doing so much for the tanking as well. The team will be picked off. The time of team out from the Weaver. In the meantime, he will survive in the background. So they already got 3 kills. Smoke in the meantime. He's going to be very much in trouble. Does not survive. He gets hit. What they're doing, Gabby, does he just go up at the high ground, get a little couple of off, and he's going to be picked up. Coming back, but in the meantime, he brings them back. The Abaddon will be picked off. The Aegis gets popped. The Omnis is going to be used by side while he gets a kill on the Sanctuary as well. In the meantime, that is going to be 2 people on the side of CG. He's going to be put down on the low ground. That's easy. Roger goes in, gets a combo off the CM. The drummer comes out doing a lot of damage. He might be picked off here. He will be killed. The Warlock will be killed as well. 2 people on the side of 4-5 production. As he looks as well as. Invoker as well as Weaver, not allowing this to be a lost fight that will go in. Doom comes out on the Invoker, he might be in trouble, he's going to be taking down very low Gabby. Tries to go for the back, tries to go for the tier 3 tower. He's not able to do the damage though, he doesn't get a kill, and he doesn't do nearly enough damage. As the tier 3 tower is still going to be standing, no matter what. So you can use it when you're dropping down. You can use it whenever your teammates are a little bit in trouble in the game. Might be a little bit in trouble here. Might be run down. But I'm not able to go in and help him any time as Rappy. We'll have to move himself away a little bit. They don't want to take the fight with one person down. But Rover comes in, gets him. He misses it. He hits no one at all. As the Invoker will be doomed up by the Doom. In the meantime, the buyback comes up and steals. They want to take this one. They want to. They do not want to let this be a loss. In the meantime, does not get his timeless off in time. That armor stretch will be able to bring him down. The Invoker in the back line is not able to do anything to help us. That Doom is keeping his control grab in the meantime. Does not have his ultimate result in the next 12 seconds. That's going to be the Abaddon. Not better for surviving. Okay, Abaddon will be controlled in mid lane, but Hopper's ultimate might be able to fight a little bit further here. Looks like he's going to be able to get a lot of HP back there. He's trying to get a little bit further here. He's got the last 7 seconds to back in himself, so he's going to be able to survive not 7 seconds before the next one be available. But he'll be picked off armor slash gets used to make sure they get the kill on him. In the meantime, Jonah might be able to get in trouble. CM goes for his ultimate, might be able to get solo kill on Sideboard. Sideboard gets taken down by Fly Solo. CM finding a kill on that guy. Gem gets dropped down, and the CM will be picking that up as well. Doom in the meantime will be controlled. Looks like they're going to be riding in the meantime as Weaver's in the enemy base. Amal's going to be pushing the bottom and trying to go for the Merrick's down here, and they're doing so much damage to the enemy base as the general does not have his Omnis Dash available. He does not have his buyback available. He cannot do anything. In the meantime, they tried to survive. The Doom is trying to fight up against the tank as CM, but they're not allowing him to come back to the base. They're not allowing him to defend, and he will be picked off. CM barely surviving. He might be killed here. He's taking a lot of damage attack. And it looks like he actually will be killed. They need to go in. They need to deny him for the love of God. And yeah, then we'll go for the deny. The gem will be picked up as a fight before the Warlock can even react to buyback. It could be great. Then look at the Warlock could buy back. Those probably going to be available. The Abaddon City behind the game, so that it can be fine. Thank you, goes in. Goes for a bar. In the meantime, the mid rex has been taken, and the bottom rex has been taken out by the Invoker in the meantime, so that is going to be Mega Creeps. They pop the smoke as well, and well, CG, they force Mega Creeps. GG gets all those small player productions. They just feel like, you know, they just fought Mega Creeps. They just fought out Mega Creeps inside of CG. So if they can't fight them and defend the base, make sure that the Rax doesn't fall down, they're not going to be able to fight them anyways. So they call the GG, and that is going to be it. That is going to be a CG to win this series 2-0.